taught public school here for 28 years at the Holland Public Schools. And so Holland is just really as much my home as Zealand is, in fact, maybe a little more so than Holland. And as the story goes on, you'll hear enough about me personally, but if you find that you are interested and want to understand a little bit more about my life and what I do, there is a paper back here that you're welcome to pick up. And if you're finding that anybody else might be interested in hearing about Reconnective Healing, feel free to take the things that are up here. There is also brochures besides the big. Some of you may have already seen these. These are postcards that have my name on the back, so people can know how to contact me, and it also tells a little bit about Reconnective Healing. This is basically the same thing, but this one is written by Dr.EricPearl and given to us to be able to hand to people to help understand a little bit, but it does have my name and number on there. So if you would like them, please take them. And if you know someone that you think, oh, you know what, I would like to give this to someone, please do that. I am more than happy to do that. Also, the Light Gap is a book that I wrote, and as you'll see, I wrote this book before I found Reconnective Healing. And it really literally is the journey that I took from my near-death experience to where I am now and where my yearning for understanding healing began in 1982, back during my near-death experience. Often when I'm presenting the story of my near-death experience, and I'm also presenting the story of my sister Marge Snyder, who lives in Winnetka, so she taught in, she lived in Wellmap, then she taught in Winnetka, and she lives in Norfolk. There you go. Anyway, she and I wrote the book together, and she is just, I want to let you know, just one of these absolutely special people who really helps people through understanding the journey beyond grief. We all have to face grief. We face it from, you know, many, many corners of the earth and reasons. But for her, she lost her daughter when she was 19, and that was my niece. And our lives grew and threaded together. But she is such an inspiration to people of how we move beyond that grief. And that story isn't told in the Light Gap, so if anybody is interested in that, I do sometimes. Anybody wants it. Or if you're just wanting to go on our website and read a little bit more, this card tells you something too, and just feel free to take any of those things. So,
does that have anything to do with an audiobook?
No. It's in an ebook. It is an ebook, but it's never made into an audiobook.
But you can listen to ebooks.
Can you possibly?
I don't know. I'm just thinking about people who, like my girlfriend, really has a hard time reading.
I love her.
To listen to this. She listens to books, okay. But she can't read.
How about we check into that? Because that is actually a feedback we've had before. That there's, you know, a lot of people who have struggled with the that concept. So, the earning concept. That ability to really see.
Right.
Now, Reconnective Healing is newer to me, but the understanding behind energy healing is not new to me. When I had my near-death experience in 1982, I was absorbed into an incredible light, and I could tell everyone exactly what happened in the hospital room where I was revived. And I was outside of my body, but that is significant in some ways, because in Reconnective Healing, we are experiencing that light, that whole concept of energy, light, and information, which is spoken about in here, and I'm going to go through it hopefully slowly enough, and I would really love to have you ask questions, not only wait and keep them all at the end, but if there's something that I'm saying or whatever, please, this is a nice-sized group. I really enjoy talking to a group this size because it gives us a chance to really interact with each other. For many people, the whole concept of energy healing is new, or they've heard about it in other ways. And so they, you know, they go, what is Reconnective Healing? What are all these different energy types of healings that maybe some of you have experienced. And that's one of my first questions for you. And that is, have you experienced any type of healing, energy healing? Has anyone?
Well, you have. Yeah, I have few classes that I've taken. I've taken some of my sexual classes, John Barnes. And those is the no-touching classes that happen. And I had an out-of-body experience, which was something I wasn't expecting in the class. As a workshop, it was a long class of 2 days. But that's, and then I did do Reiki. And I did do some Reiki, and I thought that was also kind of ethereal. For me, it was kind of an ethereal kind of experience. But I haven't reconnected with that stuff, which is why I'm here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Anybody else?
So, right. Right. Well, and for some of us,
I'm in touch.
You
what? Taking classes in quantum touch.
In quantum touch.
Reiki, 1, 2, 3, 4, starting through the toes, and also down the line.
Yeah, I totally, we have to validate all of these types because we're all in this learning curve. And none of us just know the answers from A to Z about how our universe operates. And so the more we understand, the more we can put it into a framework that's going to work for us.
Terry, I also want to say this, that how would book open into this?
Okay.
How would book?
Yeah.
Well, things, in other words, the other experience that I had was a long time ago, but because of your book and because of my doing work after that, it made me
Thank you.
And I think it's maybe because of Marge. Looking at Marge and saying, really, Marge? And being able to, and really wanting to go that route and find out what's happening. So, thank you.
Thank you for sharing that. Does anybody else have anything they want to share before we start? Okay. Now, in reconnective healing, in my journey to discover it, I wanted to let you know that part of what happened to me was that because I had been studying various types and kinds of healing, that I needed to go from my MDE to what healing practices were all about. And that came about because, of course, nobody dies for a reason that they don't have to heal afterwards, and obviously, and I was in a terrible car accident, so I had a lot of healing that came after that, but I healed extremely quickly to the point where my doctor kept saying, I don't understand this. This would normally take you 6 months, a month into the healing, the 2 months. So I healed much faster than most people. That's what finally helped me to open my mouth and tell the doctor and say, okay, I have to tell you my story, because in 1982, I didn't know the word near-death experience, but I won't talk to anyone else. I was scared to death to even open my mouth, and that's part of the story that's in there. It's helping people realize that you have a lot to give, offer, and share. But it took me an incredibly long time. But to the healing practices, I began to realize that I had discovered something about the energy field around my body during my near-death experience, and I didn't even know it. I began to experience a lot of very odd things that would happen around me. I would affect lights, I would affect computers. I couldn't keep a watch operating. They never last very long. I affect the electromagnetic fields that I am close into. And it would be years later before I'd find out that, oh, that's a common trait of someone who's had a near-death experience. But it isn't just that I have that experience. It is every single one of us are absolute divine creations of God. And we are all built alike. We all have these same gifts that someone comes back and for a long time my ego kind of went way too high where I could say, oh my gosh, that was that just a gift for me? But of course you don't want to not think of it as a gift because I learned and I felt absorbed into knowledge that after years of researching, and because I was a science major in my career in science and math, my husband chuckles. He's back there behind the camera, by the way. And one day I say, well, I'm a math major, but anyway, that took me researching, and I have read for literally for 30 some years, reading everything I could to understand the science behind what was happening. Now, the practices that I got into after my MD were many varied, and over many years, learning yoga, learning from a person, Dr. Kulso, who put out a CD and book called Meditation as Medicine, healing codes, Qigong, Tai Chi, tapping, energy medicine, and for all of you that get to come to this absolutely wonderful facility and do yoga with these lovely ladies back here, Lorraine and Melanie, for all of you who have not met the owners of the 43 Wellness Center, and some of you already know them, they are sitting towards the back right there, and I just want to thank them for allowing me to come in, share my knowledge, and also practice, and be able to share and help people. Because this is where I would get frustrated. I would learn all these different things that I could do to help myself. And I already began sharing them with other people. You gotta try this. These kinds of things really work. And so, you know, please, that I would explain why the things in science that I learned. But I never had a further step to go with it. How can I have, besides sharing what I've learned, where was another set of understanding that I can go to? And I had also done some research into Reiki too, but I never was trained. I did some online courses, listened to webinars, and did some of those. And you'll see later, I was introduced to another person who really made a difference in my understanding, but that came much later, that just before I met Dr. Pearl. No, after. Yes, just before. But finding that frequency of love, light, and information is something that we all can do. And this is one of the things that I found when I picked up this book. I heard EricPearl speak in Chicago. And immediately it was like, I've got to learn that. He's got the pieces that are fitting what I understand. And he's telling everybody that we can heal others, but we can heal ourselves. And that every single one of us, we don't have to have or be in this special category of people to say, yes, you're a healer. It isn't like that. And the vibration that happens in my body, how many of you experience that when something really, really intricately wonderful has happened in your life, that your body begins to vibrate a little bit and you feel a tingling in it and you think, for me it took a long time for me to say, that's validating what I have learned. It's validating, yes. That's it. So finding that frequency was something I was attempting to do. Now this is a quote by Rumi, but your body is woven from the light of heaven. Of course, Rumi lived, you know, long, long ago. And people have understood the energy around the body for centuries and centuries. Yoga, Qigong, Tai Chi, those are all ancient practices. And our Western medicine kind of pushed those out of the way for a while, but it's getting pushed back in. And I'm so thrilled to find that all of these are now being pushed back in. Because when I found and listened to him speak, I could connect absolutely right away to some of the things that he was saying. For other people, it was new information, and so it took a little longer to really connect and understand. Now, not only is he validating these things, but the many, many, many scientists that I've read, and some of my favorites, you'll hear me say their names periodically, who I learned from, Bruce Lipton, Greg Braden, and I don't know if you're familiar. familiar with any of these people, Dr. Joe Dispenza. They are out there helping all of us take our spiritual life and move it into our physical life. Mind, body, spirit, those three words are there for a reason, because they are all interconnected. That I experienced in my near-death experience very strongly, because out of my body, and when I was being absorbed in the light, I could see my life before me and realize that every single person I met was connected to me. And not only that, every single person on the planet is connected with one another. That's a huge concept. And when I came back with that, it took me years to understand that that means what I do can affect somebody on the other side of the planet. The way I am can affect somebody sitting right in this room, but I don't have to be sitting right next to this room to actually affect another person. Connecting that light and healing through the connection is part of what Reconnective Healing is all about. That's why he uses that term. We are reconnecting to our source. And our human bodies are connected through our source, through God. When we think about what's happening in our body and things going wrong, we tend to want to move, believe me, I was right there with you. I could identify where it was like, okay, what can we do to fix me? Okay, what can we do to fix me? And I went through a whole nother healing journey finding this out. In 2008, I became extremely sick. I had stories in the book too, and how I climbed out of it. After being put on every medication, I had lists along with me, taking it to the doctor each time and going, you've got a neurologist, and you've got a cardiologist, and you've got a general and internal medicine, and you've got all these different doctors, and it's like, yes, and it's not working. It is not good. It is not. This is not. And I totally lost it when they just say, I didn't come back to life to live like this. And I know there's more. And oh my goodness, I have this message. It says, Jerry, you know how to heal. Get at it. And it's like, goodness, I do. And that was an eye-opener for me. It took me 2 years. I not only got help, but oh, I wish I'd known about the healing back then, or better than I do now, because I didn't. And I didn't know about Reconnective Healing, so I didn't go. Oh, I would have healed faster had I gone. And I didn't do it. But I did do it for myself. The biggest aha from science that we all should make sure we're embracing, and that is that we're not stuck with our DNA. We all think we are. This has been told to us for a long time, that, okay, if my mom had heart disease or whatever, I'm likely to pick that up. I'm likely to be part. But I was told all those things as sick as I was. But yet at the same time, the truth is we can change that DNA. Science has now proven that. That needs to be on the outside page of magazines everywhere, and saying, you know, they've discovered that the environment around us can change the DNA. Now, environment is not just where you're living or what kind of situation you're living in. That affects it too. How are we in our emotional life is huge. But also, it has to do with the fact that our bodies are not exactly the way we kind of think that they are. And I'm going to read this one because I want to make sure that you understand that this quote from Deepak Chopra is just very, very significant. And I want you to be looking at the lines around this person, and I'll show you why in a minute. There has been a revolution in how we perceive the body. What appears to be an object, here I am, feeling,
a three-dimensional anatomical structure. That's what we think we are, three-dimensional. All right. In this body, we call our human part. And is actually a process and a constant flow of energy and information. And what that means is, this is our human body. We have a spirit body too. And we tend to not want to, we tend to separate them. And that's what learning that we're all connected has really done for me. It's helped me realize, no, not separated. That part of us lives right inside of this human part of us that we call ourself. We're the ones who keep trying to separate it. But really, it's all one, and we are very connected to our source. When we open that door, we open that portal inside of us that says, we are connected. Now that constant flow of energy, that's what's around our bodies all the time. As you can see, and you can look at many, many photographs of what the energetic body looks like, you'll see a few more. But the core of our body, the chakras that we talk about, the energy centers, whatever names we want to give them, doesn't matter. And I'm going to explain a bit more about them. But it's not just inside this body. It's outside. Scientists have also proved that our consciousness does not live just inside our brain. It's there, but it's also in every single cell in our body. Quantum physics has proven that. And not only is it in every cell of our body, but it's in a field that is way around us, on the outside of our body. That's where I feel like I've been a gift, given a gift. My near-death experience helped me understand that field outside my body. I was looking at a body on a table that was gone. They were inviting me during the whole cold blue and all that. Doctors left one at a time, and that was my body down there. But I was outside of it, up above it, and I was thinking totally logically, that's my doctor, Dr. Rich. How did he find me? How did he get in here so quick? Yes, there was an accident. Yes, my husband was with my two young children, and taking because he had been in the car with me, and he was taking them to be checked out. But yet, I could see that they were fine. How am I able to do that? We can. We are not just inside our body. We are all around it. And the information about us, about the person, is all around us as well. It is not just how it's right here. And brain scientists now are sharing that information. In the longer workshop, I'm able to go and share some of the things that the brain researchers are showing us. But finding the frequencies is what's important when we go into reconnective healing. I've been feeling those frequencies for a very, very long time, but I didn't realize that that's what it was. For me, for the most part, I was learning it through meditation. And the deeper and deeper I was able to figure out meditation, the deeper I would get my body into a state that I was feeling those frequencies. And it was healing me. And it now is a continuous healing that I think happens daily as I meditate. But we still, every one of us, are still bombarded by things that are out of our control. Environment, that is what's, but now, that ultimate healing frequency, I never felt 1 ounce of pain once I left that body at all. There was peace and love. Such an incredible love. Love that brought instant healing. I wasn't hurting anywhere. I was trying to say to the doctors, and realized I wasn't able to communicate, I'm fine. It's beautiful. What are you so worried about? I'm okay. And then realizing, they're not even that out there. But light and being a that light is the highest form of energy that we have. Now, one of the problems with that statement is that we all picture the kind of light we're looking at here, or we picture the sun, which it holds an incredible amount of energy in it. But again, light is more, much more complicated than that. But actually, that light lives right within us. It's waiting for us to bring it on out. As we look at those chakras and why it took me a long time. I studied them all, and there's a chapter in my book that talks all about the chakras and all understanding about it. But it took me the longest time for somebody to say, you realize that the color red vibrates at that same energy level as that part of your body in that chakra. I didn't know that. That vibrational level has been measured now, and red vibrates at that color, but so do certain emotions. And we tend to bring out the negative emotions that can happen and get directed in all of these chakras, but finding the really true beautiful ones is one that I have found. And thinking of a real photograph showing you exactly that our energy centers within our bodies are a spiraling vortex of energy, but they're connected by all kinds of connecting things. The acupuncture points, that whole grid, and when you hear about reconnection, reconnective healing, the reconnection is helping us get our bodies connected to the grid that is lives every single body across the planet. This is not special to any one person or anybody. But we are also intricately connected to the world, to the earth. Now, I spoke about Greg Braden just a little bit. I have studied through him again and again, and he's just a brilliant man who can put it down on our level so we can understand. But he helped me to really understand that the heart is actually more powerful than our brain. And we don't think of it that way. But yet it's not only more powerful for us in our life, in sharing love with other people, finding love for ourselves, but it's also actually physically more powerful. And these quotes are coming from science, that the heart is 100,000 times stronger electrically. Now, we know we have an electric field around us. We also have a magnetic field, and they are combined. And much more powerful than the brain. And when that heart connects in what they call coherence with our brain, which is what we do during yoga, we do it during any kind of energy type healing, but we also do connect it during meditation in a very strong way usually. But recognizing that your heart is that center, that's what's connecting you to the world and to other people. If I can share just one thing with you, dip your hands on the side. Okay, we're going to play with energy a little bit later, but taking your hands and just pick up a ball, because we're going to pick up a ball later too, and just make it that ball just as soft as mine. Feel like it's squishy. Thank you. just close your eyes for a second. Your brain feels what you're feeling in your heart. Is my heart showing and feeling the love that I feel right now for all of you? My goodness. Because I know how intricately connected we all are. And I feel that love. But what is happening is your brain is listening to what your heart is feeling. Your brain will send chemicals that your heart tells it to. That frequency of love getting coherent with my brain. Now, in now workshops with Greg Brady have shown us actual graphs where they put all the notes on your head and on your heart and whatever, and they're showing what's happening in the heart, what's happening in the brain. And that is what coherence means, that it's working together. In other words, now, if I all of a sudden hit that tree like I did when I was in my car accident, I was like, well, that sent a message to my brain too, like, that's the fight or flight or whatever. And of course, there's everything and that is actually a physical, energy in and around your body. And you begin to be able to, when you open your mind to it, begin to be able to feel it. But the biggest aha, in 2001, they discovered that the heart actually has a small brain inside of it. And they have now located it, and it is there. It holds memory. That is quite an amount to us. It holds memory from even way back when we were two, and we don't think that's back in our subconscious now. Actually, things that happen to us up until 6, 7 years old, they live in our subconscious a lot too. When you think about all of the energies that flow in and around our bodies, that is what energy can do for us. Yeah. Jillian and Eric Pearl, who, you know, go to the website and see him, and he'll talk, and I'm going to have him talk to you for just a few minutes in a minute. I'm going to turn this off, but we're going to listen to him. But when you are at a workshop with them, oh my goodness, the whole dynamics in the room is incredible. And for the most part, some of the initial trainings, the online course starts, is what I took first. Then the initial training is actually done with a pretty large group. The next training is done with a very small group. And it is a very intense, hands-on training. I just now came back from a training for all of us that have been trained. And, you know, an ongoing education to help us to share this with other people and make sure that we're doing things that are helping us all out. But one of the things that Jillian keeps talking about, and others, I'm sure you've read too, and are telling us, you know, our human body, and I'm going to stand for just a minute, and you should stand too. Our bodies are literally built kind of like, now we can have the conception, because we've got TV and we've got our cell phones that work all by themselves, and they don't need a cord and all those kind of things. Well, guess what? Either. You're a living Bluetooth. And that living Bluetooth is connecting you with the energy field that exists around the world, as well as around your body, as well as with each other. So that my energy field, my energy field interacting with your energy field is what combines when we are both connected to that source. When we do reconnective healing, and again, would you put your hand up for just a minute? Do you mind?
Yeah.
Go up here, put it this way, but you can open it a bit. And you might want to try this with even somebody by you in just a minute and see what happens. But as just hold it, however, and as we begin to new energy field. Quite frequently, when we do this, you know, people's fingers start to move too.
Yeah.
And relax.
It starts to like spark a little bit, like I can feel.
You can feel it in there. And when, thank you for allowing me to do that. When we discover that that energy field around us is very active, it takes training for our brains to really take in and say, oh, wait a minute, I am feeling that. And again, I feel like I have had a gift because mine was probably jump-started a lot by my negative experience because I was experiencing that energy field so really. And it was always fun to hear someone's entertaining story about walking by a streetlight and having it go off and 10 feet away and go back on. So it was, I mean, it was just funny things. And one of my very first workshops, he, who has passed at this point in time, said, you know, oh, I know you affect the energy field of the lights, the lit ones in the closet have gone off three times while you're talking. And it usually is because I am resonating with the energy. Not that every day I go by things and affect them. I've learned how to just let it go. But I have learned how to capture it when it comes, to capture that. And that is a big part of our training. Now, when you think about, you know, one of the things that story that Eric tells me, and again, I've heard this many times, we use the light gap as an analogy for the seeds that grow within us that have been placed here when we were born. We have that living, beautiful light right within us. But sometimes we diminish that candle in there. If you want to view it like that, but that's an analogy. That's a real thing. But it's in there. Now, if you think about just over the centuries even, Tesla, you know, if you want to find the secrets of the universe, thinks in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. And look how, what an amazing accomplishment that he's done. Now, if you also take your hands and think of how a flower blossoms, and your hands are the flower, and as it emerges, there's a lot of information there. Up But when you move down, on down, right here, if you want to re-listen to this again another time, is...
My name is EricPearl. I'm the founder of the Reconnection.
You can stick here.
Yes, but the core of the Reconnection essence of our most organic human form. It transcends our perceived limitations of our human ability and imagination. By learning to be in this awareness, you become these frequencies, and they become you. And you are able to immediately establish the most coherent cellular level of balance and harmony with all aspects of life that may have otherwise seemed impossible. We call this life progress. You call it a test of one's sin. If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. If you were to take two protons and blow each of them up to the size of an orange, the actual distance between the two would be equivalent to 2 to 2.5 football fields in length. Science has determined that what we perceive as our reality is mostly empty space. But what is empty space? And is it really empty? Picture these two protons again. No matter how hard we try to get them to stand still, they continue to vibrate, even if their dial is set to zero. Everything vibrates constantly, and this vibration creates a field that connects everything and everyone to everything and everyone. A field of infinite potential in which information is shared instantaneously between particles, no matter where they are in the universe. Through Reconnective Healing, we access this quantum field and the information contained, and it is through this connection that our frequency changes, our vibration establishes a higher resonance. All that cannot vibrate at this new speed, this new resonance, simply falls away. And this begins to include most discomfort and disease. This interaction made possible with Reconnective Healing is much more than that. Because it is not just healing, as we may think about healing. That is why we call it life progress. What is life progress? Becoming more than we are. It's living with a certainty and inside knowingness. It's awareness of one's true purpose in life, of freedom and understanding of our connection to the universe, and therefore to one another. It is the spark that is igniting our evolution, our naturalness as living human vessels connected to everything. This is exciting. The Reconnective Healing is leading this new course of life. Learn how you can share this evolutionary process for yourself, your family, and friends. As our students are discovering for themselves, the Reconnective Healing online course is the perfect tool for jump-starting our own personal evolution, our own life and progress, and in doing so, to help raise the consciousness of the planet towards a better world.
The idea of Reconnective Healing is to not keep having to give you healing sessions forever. That isn't the idea. That's why when I think about back on my own healing, I wish I had Reconnective Healing, that I could have gotten it existed back then, I just didn't know. But when we experience Reconnective Healing, it's opening things in you so that you can bring in the self-healing for yourself. In other words, I'm going to, you know, do healings and give myself on the job. Doesn't that sound awesome? Wouldn't you love to have the world be put into that place where we are really literally helping enough that then you begin bringing that healing in for yourself? And that is where the many, many stories of Reconnective Healing and what they've healed has been incredible.
they have many stories on the website that you can go and read. They've cured, their people have cured everything from, believe it or not, cerebral palsy to cancer. And these are real stories. His books are filled with some of those stories. The second book that he wrote with some of the person who was helping him channel the information initially, it started in this, it's called Holland Speaks, and it's really quite an amazing story. This one is one that I don't necessarily say, okay, everybody, you gotta go buy this, but it's the science that is confirming reconnective healing, all of the studies that have been done. And they are many, many, many. And as you can see, it's quite a scientific textbook type thing. But basically what it's doing is they have now are far enough in the research, about 8 to 10 years now, where the research is confirming what's been happening, and they're confirming with the people that have been healed by even taking their doctor records and showing the changes. So there is a lot that is being proven. But I am really not the healer. I'm a catalyst to allow the healing to come through me and to you and with you. It's a common piece that we would have together. In other words, I have to get myself into the healing. My hands are in and around people. And I hope that you don't, you know, it doesn't feel, you know, just really, really odd to have that happen. But we don't actually touch anyone. And when we are moving healing, we begin to feel where energy is all of a sudden moving. Now, I might be standing right here, and I'm feeling a stuck energy, but I don't know for sure where it is in that body. Sometimes I can't, because I'm right by it. It's like, oh, okay, all of a sudden I'm feeling it and then moving that energy. When I'm further away, believe it or not, I can still feel that energy in her. In distance, that's because of the way our universe is built. It's the way it's made. And so there's actually the three different types. Reconnective healing is a session that I'm beginning to do here now. Thank you to these wonderful ladies who are allowing me to use the healing room here. And so I, you know, they have a wonderful bed and place for me to be. So, and I'm more than happy to facilitate healing for anyone. Or if you know of some people, the reconnected healing session, my charge is $75. And basically, I'm having to remind myself to get out of the way. Mind has to get out of the way that I know where you need to be healed. It's not me. It's the universe that knows, and it's your body that knows, and it's the information that's living around your body that knows where that healing has to go. And it's 30 minutes on the table, but there's a talk before and a talk afterwards, and we go through, you know, some things to help you. Now, the reconnection is a two-time thing, and it's only in a once in a lifetime. I'd love to do that to anybody more than once. It's a once in a lifetime thing. And it's an accelerated path. As you read this, you'll get a better idea. It's an accelerated path to help you connect to your life, to yourself, and the stories that you hear from people about how their life opened up after some of these sessions. It's very incredible, and I can honestly say that. Now, the resource of the reconnection is always there for anybody. And theirs is very simple, www.reconnection.com. And they have not only these magazine articles, I printed here just in case somebody wants to see some of them. They have magazine articles, they have videos, they have lots and lots of different information. And that's a resource for you. The Light Gap is a resource for you as well. And one of the real learnings that I found is that healing yourself is remembering that you are your body.
it's not a religion. It just is the knowing of being connected. That's what we yearn for. And sometimes that's what's trapped in our body. And it's causing difficulties inside of our body. When we realize that we're all created with that divine perfection, we're going home in divine perfection. You're sitting here right now in divine. You are a piece of divine. You are with them. All of a sudden, everyone is sorry. I'm happy to have you visit me at the light camp. There's just one thing I'm going to show you here, and that is when I began to study. This goes way back to some of my old presentations. But in case you are interested, just exactly where all the different emotions in your body fall. This is Dr. David Hawkins, which I have learned a ton from. I've read all of his books. Some of them very deep. He's going now as well. But his work will live forever. But all of the different emotions were calibrated and put into, counted the different emotions calibrated. And if you look at his chart, you realize that even when we look at it just for ourselves, that, joy and love and peace are way up here. But even the shame, guilt, apathy, grief, fear, desire, anger, pride, all those things that we get into in the very middle of it, we're running up and down. We don't just sit in this same place. We love to be right up here. I don't think I'm going to put myself up there with the masters of the world. But when we, the more that love comes out, the more you're bringing those frequencies in into your body. Reconnective healing and reconnection can help connect you to that. And I had a person who really wanted to be here tonight. And she said, okay, would you please read this verse for me? Sometimes when you read something about yourself, you feel a little odd, but I'm going to read it. It was an email sent to me just a couple days ago that she was not able to be here. She wanted me to read this. Reconnective healing has changed my life. I have lived my whole life with stomach digestive issues, and it only got worse after I had my daughter 5 years ago. I tried everything. Every specialist, naturalist, etc., but nothing changed my situation. Energy healing was something I never knew existed, but after much prayer, I asked God to show me how or where to find healing. I became desperate and hopeless. The very next morning, God gave me a very clear direction through a series of events that led me to watching The Living Matrix, a documentary on YouTube. The moment I saw Dr. Pearl, my heart about leaped out of my chest. I didn't know anything about him or what he was doing. But every cell in my body knew that this was how healing was supposed to happen for me. I was ready to fly anywhere to see him, so I immediately got on his website to figure out my options. To my surprise, Eric had been teaching people all over the world this work. The second surprise was finding Terry Larkin listed in the practitioner as a practitioner right up the road from where I live in Hudsonville. I called Terry minutes later, and she actually answered my call. I was speechless. I was crying. I was grateful and excited all at the same time. The next day, Terry did a reconnective healing session on me, and every single issue I had immediately disappeared. I could talk for hours about that actual session and the things I experienced, but that's a separate story. I have only had one reconnective healing session, but it has forever changed my life, and so much that I went and became trained a practitioner myself. Thank you, Terry, for bringing awareness to the people. Michigan. Michelle Henderson, Hudsonville, Michigan. She said to share with you who she is because it was very difficult in her life. And I ended up doing healing on her 5-year-old daughter who was very anxiety driven, and her husband who's a chiropractor as well. So there's many other stories I can share. But now, what can I answer for you? Our time is up. And I know that your time is precious. And the center's time is precious. And I would love to answer any questions that I can. And if there's anything that just seems very muddy to you, please speak up because it might be just as muddy to send it over here. And sometimes we are afraid to speak up. Usually someone else, yes.
So this started with a topic and a job?
Yes.
So are you asking like specific questions about it?
No.
No.
That only what you want to share is ever asked, because that concept of the fact that your body knows where it's going to heal and you know where it needs to go. And it might be that you've got a problem, like she was talking about, lives here, but actually it might be living up here. And so when we send healing, we're sending healing to the whole body. And again, yes, when we feel a particular place, then we'll work harder on that place. But do we know exactly where it's going? No. No, we don't. We can hold. And we always, you know, if our ego tries to get in the way, and our ego is trying to say, okay, let that ego get out of the way. Don't let yourself get into that trap, because truly, we can be a gift to each other, to different people.
For instance, in the case of Mrs. Henderson, she was came to you very open and very willing, and very eager. Does it seem to make a difference in the state of the person's mind or will?
Yeah. The studies are showing no. Your mind says yes. And my mind keeps saying yes if a person's open with that, open the door easier. But the studies are showing, they have many, many people come in going, you gotta be kidding. Or a husband or a wife, you know, drank their husband or their wife. It's like, oh, give this a try, because, you know. And they're like, oh my goodness. So in tracking those, they have found that it is not bearing that the person is open to it themselves.
I got a chance to spend time with Terry, and I saw her give a presentation in January, and I spent 3 months. I was doing some PT, okay, and when that was done, I was able, I know that I was not able to stand here and walk, or to stand here as I was the first of the year. Okay, I was not able to just stand here and not fall down, okay? And between the PT and spirit and whatever was going on, I broke an ankle and I had 6 surgeries on it, and after being I had a hard time walking around, but I was hoping that this foot was no longer the same. It wasn't the same as my right foot. And so 2 days after, it was a week ago, and I got up out of bed and, you know, I said, oh, this foot feels so short. It's like, wait a minute. And not realizing that both feet were now equal. Okay? And I've been able to re-walk for the last week. Okay? So that they're just, I can walk better, okay? And so, it's one of the things that has begun to happen just in what's happened in, and so I'm just grateful. And I live in Grand Rapids, and I was just pleased that I would be able to be here today too. I didn't
know I
would say anything, but it works. for me.
Okay? Spirit, God, universe, wherever. Okay? It just, goodness is what God wants. All of us. And then we can learn so that we can share that with the people who are around us. Become very shy, very depressed and everything. And it was a very difficult time, but it's been a process. It's in this process. And I'm looking for the next 20, you know. So I'm happy. That's my answer.
A lot of people need healing or on a lot of pharmaceuticals. Uh-huh. And those will change the body chemistry and suppress certain things in the immune system and so on. Does that interfere with the energy and then you feel the healing?
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. Because, you know, some, yes, she's got a story about medication. I'm not going to tell any of her stories because that's her. But very often, reconnective healing has been used with, for instance, cancer patients as they're going through chemo, and they have pulled away the nausea that comes with it. They've pulled away, I mean, they've made enough change so that someone can, yes, use what they need and have to have. And yet this enhances it and helps work it out and work it through. So, you know, never are advocating that anybody, I mean, I was telling my own story of getting off medications, but, you know, because I went off all of mine, but that was with Dr. Helen. And believe me, my neurologist and my GP are like, you know, up here in my mind, that I needed them to help me to do it. And I needed to prove to myself what I was putting in its place. You can't just will yourself to help if that's what you're thinking. You hear that also a lot, you know, that your positive thoughts can really make a difference. And yes, they make a huge difference, but can they heal you? That's not practical. We can't just will ourselves. Believe me, if I could have willed myself well, but I would ask my doctor, please, can I begin to decrease this one or take this away or whatever? And they would say, oh no. And I was still on the same three meds I was still taking from 95, okay, until September. And I got a new doctor. It's like three of them she was able to take off, you know, within maybe 6 weeks. Okay, but that's because I was on the wrong kind of stuff and I was taking too much, and no wonder I was so depressed, and no wonder I couldn't talk, no wonder I couldn't walk, you know. So a lot has happened, you know, just in this process. I'm just grateful that, you know, I still have some money, okay, and I will just be with taking what I need to take, and just know that I have a good life.